Elkingham.
Good evening, Elkingham, and welcome to a live show here in the studio on Sunday, the 3rd of December, and thanks for joining us. We have got a lot to go this evening, as we haven't been in the studio together for about 3 weeks.
I know, it's been a while, isn't it?
Too long, but hey.
Well, you can tell how unprofessional we are, because I'm going to have to bail off camera, otherwise we're not going to be able to do phone calls. Totally unprepared, so I will see you in a second.
Well, you can see him, can't you? It's alright, just trying to keep up with Altrincham today. Oh my god, Altrincham, wow. Was everyone at the Lantern Parade yesterday? Wow, what an atmosphere. Fantastic, everyone joining in, singing and dancing, Christmas songs. Oh, Christmas is on its way.
It is, it's coming!
Oh yay, Christmas!
Christmas is coming.
It is.
Right.
Just a bit.
I'm gonna have to leave again. I'll see you in a sec.
Oh dear.
Okay, I'm good to go this time. I'm good to go. So, what have you been up to, Chris? You were hosting.
I was hosting at the Altium Limited Lantern Parade yesterday.
Yeah.
Which was really good to be included with, you know, because like, you know, because it's volunteering, anyone can be hosting for Altrincham. It's just a few hours a day, or it's like an event like Goose Green, Altrincham Festival, and you can even help on the Altrincham Bloom, which we're on the committee, but they need some help on the volunteering side as well, don't they, Andy?
They do, yeah. Sarah Wormsley from our Altrincham in Bloom, oh, we're crying out for volunteers. They've just not got enough volunteers, guys. Are you green fingered? Are you green toed even? Are you red arsed? No. Are you green fingered? And Altrincham in Bloom, crying out for volunteers. Why not get involved? We were doing a little bit for Bloom last week, weren't we?
Yes, on Wednesday.
On the
full Wednesday. That's just gone. Yeah.
On the Four Seasons Walkway.
Yeah.
In the cold and the wet for you, Altrincham.
Yes, for Altrincham, yes.
Yeah, that was fun. It's nice though when we do a little bit out in Altrincham, and the people that come past and say doing a fantastic job. People really appreciate the work that Altrincham in Bloom do. So if you fancy volunteering, I'm sure on Altrincham in Bloom's website, which is www.altringhaminbloom.org.uk, I'm sure you'll be able to register as a volunteer. Give it a go, why don't you?
Yeah, it is quite good to be part of the community.
It is, it's nice, yeah. Anthony Brown, hi lads. Great to meet you in Costa last night. Chris, have you been out and about?
Yes, I have.
We do let him out now and again.
Yeah, on my own, of course. I was having a latte, charging my batteries when
excuse me, a latte?
Oh yes, because we with that breaking news we did, which we will come up to, we'll have a schedule for that. So I had to go and definitely go and charge my batteries and have a large latte and just concentrate on this story.
Is that what keeps you going, a large latte? You like a large one, don't you?
Who doesn't?
Say no more. Speak for yourself. I'm going to have to start wearing... somebody bought me some off-the-shelf reading glasses a little while back. And as the weeks go on, I find I need them more and more.
Well, you do with all the things you're doing at the moment, Andy.
I'm going to have to... in fact, shall I?
No.
Shall I? I'll sit here in my specs like you.
No, don't be daft. Don't be taking the mix.
I've tried your specs on before, haven't I? And it's like, oh my lord! So, guys, yeah, please join in the comments while we're here. Or, look at that, you can give us a call. 07874055611. We'd love to hear off you.
Yeah.
And talk about your week in Altrincham like we're talking about ours. So what else have you been up to, Chris?
Me? I've just been busy. Just trying to sort a lot of things out, like you, Andy.
Jack Owens is saying, can we get a shout out to churchgoers on Sundays?
Oh, good for that.
Why not? Good on you. Not my cup of tea, I must admit, but yeah, good on you guys.
Yes, I do. I've had my hair cut.
Is it not a bit cold?
No, it isn't actually. It's nice. But it was a week on Friday. Yeah, like a week on Friday, went to the hairdressers, the new hairdressers on top of George Street. It's a barber shop. And I just went in there and just said, just get rid of it all. And I had number one all over.
You go for the rugged look?
Yeah, but at the moment I'm growing it back, don't worry.
Oh yeah?
Oh yes. Oh yes.
Are you going to go for the hippie look in the new year?
No, I don't look at now. I'm not a hippie. Don't be mean.
Okay, guys, 07-874-055-611. We'd love to hear off you. What have you been doing in Northringham today? That lantern parade was pretty busy, wasn't it? I enjoyed that.
Yeah, it was quite moving though, Andy.
Was it?
Yeah. It just felt really proud to be having something like that in Altrincham, especially something, it's much better parade than it has been in the future, in the recent years, you know, because of the overlap, the lantern parade with the lights. And I thought it was better yesterday because they get their own little slot instead of, like, you know.
Yeah, because last year, it was that lantern parade that pushed us out from the stage, isn't it? At the Christmas lights, so. Yeah, so hopefully that, we're looking how popular it was on Sunday, perhaps in years to come, over the coming years, if we're doing this every year, then it's going to be as big as Goose Green Summer Festival, which is on its way up, 2 days this year, maybe next year, it'll be a 2-day lantern parade. They're going to be tired.
Oh, God. Yeah, I think they should make the route a little bit bigger.
Marie Kirkham, Alti is the place for me.
I like Chris's haircuts, love to walk about. Oh, thank you.
Yeah, your walkabouts are back, aren't they? The next one is?
On Tuesday. And Thursday.
And Thursday?
Yes.
Twice a week?
Yeah, but...
A double dose for Chris.
Yeah, but it's... like, last week I should have been on... Well, Thursday that's just gone now. I should have been on Radio Wishing Well, but I will be back on there before Christmas. We are making a Christmas special.
We are?
On Radio Woohoo.
Are we?
We are, Andy.
Oh, okay. And when's that? This is the first I've heard of it.
Yes, I know, Andy.
Oh, right. Was this a surprise?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Hi, Mike, by the way. It's Internet Mike up there at Radio Wishing Well. He's old. Older than me, and I'm old.
He is a bit, but he's cool.
He's a good lad, Mike. Couldn't shut him up when he came down to visit us.
Yeah, it's like, wow, look at this. And it's like, yeah, look at this studio. But anyway, it was quite good. He's good. Good person.
So, yeah. Okay, guys. Thank you for the comments. Thank you for joining us. Keep the comments coming. Or the calls. 07874-055-611. Let loose about Altrincham a bit. Tell us what you've been up to. What you'd like to get up to. But be careful. What would you like to get up to?
Me?
Or should we not go there?
I don't know, Andy, because I've been really busy today at work and trying to calm myself down, and, you know, winter's here, well, but late autumn's here, and it's cold. Especially in the studio, as they say, it's nice and warm, I don't think so.
Well, do you know what? It's colder in this building than it is outside at the moment. We've got that heater going, and it's still freezing. Heat!
Yeah, we need heat in this studio.
And anyway, I don't think, I think it does qualify as winter now, December, not late autumn. And I know the tree outside my gaff has got no trees left on it, no leaves left on it. So I think it qualifies as winter.
Well, it is. It's nice and rainy today. Well, it's been raining for the last few days, but just cleared.
They were lucky yesterday with that parade, weren't they? Because
yeah,
it was
stops,
that horrible drizzly stuff all day that just sticks to you. And about an hour before the parade, it miraculously brightened up a little bit, so that was nice to see. Did you join in with the sing song?
I did. I sang my heart out. I did. It was quite nice to see all of them singing together. They should do something like that a little bit more, especially around the tree in the middle of George Street. You know, a bit of a brass band and things, and people singing away. Maybe that could be something Alton Unlimited could do next year.
I'm sure they'll be building on the success of this year, yeah. Like they did on the Goose Green Summer Festival. So, yeah, well, like we say, maybe next year, 2 full days of it.
Oh.
2 days of Christmas carols and celebration and cold, out in the cold.
Yeah, we need some fake snow though. That'd be quite good.
We were talking about that, weren't we? Well, wouldn't that be cool, a bit of fake snow with the around Goose Green where it started? We've got a snow machine there. And
yeah, the Snow Queen, the Ice Queen they had there yesterday, which followed us with the parade. That was quite good, with all them little parade lanterns dancing, and especially that scary one in front of us. He annoyed me. Sorry if you're watching. But
no, exactly,
just
one long
I had to sort of stand back with Sarah, and Sarah said, can you stop walking fast? Because you know what I'm like, I walk really fast. You know what I'm like.
Oh God, yeah. Yeah,
there's no difference. I had to keep up so many distance away from him, and I kept going behind him and everything, you know.
Hi Dylan, thanks for joining us. Miles, my eyes are shocking. I can't even read that last comment of Dylan's.
I cannot blind. Cannot. Hi guys, that was just so hi guys. Oh, yeah, and also Joe's online, who came out at Bistro Pierre on Tuesday evening. Wow, that was fantastic.
You loved that, didn't you?
I loved it when you just came running out. I'm just having me running back. I've got someone to say hello. And I was like, wow, we've got a fan with him.
That was great Altrincham TV, that was.
Yeah, I was like, wow.
So, yeah. So she's with us tonight, is she?
Yeah, she's
is
online.
She's there? Hi, how are you diddling? 07874055611, if you'd like a chat. We're here for a little while. Until we get bored, or until you get bored of us, so everybody's going to leave the page now. Having said that,
being mentioned by this local celeb, how do you feel, lads?
Do I detect a note of sarcasm in that comment? I think I do.
Well, it doesn't matter, Andy, because the thing is, though, I enjoy what I do. I really, really enjoy myself. And if people want to come up and wish me good, well, that's fine by me. I don't say, oh, yeah, sort of thing. People just like, you know.
Yeah, so knock yourself out.
Yeah.
You know where to find him. He's always on the streets. You never know what Chris is up to.
Yeah, and good reason, Andy, of course. Of course. People just sarcastic little swines. But anyway, we'll just move on, but we were talking about the lantern parade and
we were
talked and everything, you know. But Christmas is here, and there's so much going on in Altrincham that they have Christmas trees at the market start at £35.
Do they?
Yes, if you want a Christmas tree, go to the market, £35. Or there's one near the what's it called? Davidson's, you know, the Davidson's in Broadheath.
Mm-hmm.
They're offering free delivery.
What's this thing with upside down Christmas trees? Have you seen them?
Yeah, I saw one last year. We've got one.
Upside down Christmas trees.
We've just got a caller.
What's all that about? Hey, hello. Oh, is it Billy Bradshaw again? Who is it this time then?
Paul.
Oh, hey Paul. You're fine. Yeah, we're fine, how are you?
I've been a good fuck you.
Have you been good for Santa? You sound so much like that Billy Bradshaw guy we had a couple of weeks ago.
Huh?
Okay, so what have you been up to? What would you like to say to Altrincham? and be careful. Don't we all? He loves our finger, isn't that nice?
We love it too much.
We do.
We love Altrincham, that's why we work for them.
We work for Altrincham?
We do.
We do.
Do.
Of course we do.
Of course
yeah.
We do, Andy. Bloody hell, Andy, where have you been?
Yeah, we work hard for Altrincham.
See you
right. Now. Right, oh, I'm sorry, you're still there.
Suck your fucking lord.
Oh, thank you for that. Yeah.
Actually, I wish it would, but she's not here, I'm afraid.
Right, okay, sorry about
she's
that. She's
swine.
Well, there you go.
Yes. So anyway, forget about that ignorant little sod on our fit on online. If you'd like to call us, you
we
know...
We can take it. We can handle it.
Excuse me. I'm not taking anything from you, Andy. Oh, we've got a lot of people online tonight. Yes. So anyway, you know, it's... oh, dear. Anyway.
You're getting giddy, aren't you?
I'm allowed to.
Okay, that's fine.
I'm allowed.
That's fine.
Because it's people like that ignorant person that just throws your gun at you or us because they're just jealous of what we're doing.
Is that a thing, throwing your gun?
Yes.
Right, I won't pursue that one. No.
Well,
I think I better not. So, Chris, yeah, this parade last night then, We covered the whole lot, didn't we? We live streamed the whole lot from Goose Green up to the Stamford Quarter.
Yes.
And the carols and the singing afterwards. And then just after we posted our video to the page, our rather big story broke and drowned it all out, didn't it?
Yeah, thanks to Mark Pepper, one of my friends. He sent me the message to saying that the Quarry Bank pub in Timpley was on flames. And... that was quite a shock because it was like, God, get me a picture quick. So he sent me a picture and I put the little comment on there. And there were so many people sharing it and messaging. But apparently it was the log flume, the chimney.
The log flume?
Yeah, the log chimney caught on fire. But the fire brigade worked together to make it out quickly. But otherwise, the pub would have been up in flames even more. So that they came from different places around the region, which is fantastic.
Altrincham, Sale, Wythenshawe, and a command unit from Hyde, I believe. How's that for a memory? I think we might have Billy Bradshaw back. Let's give
hello.
It a go.
Hello.
Hi.
Hey, baby.
Okay, obviously Chris doesn't want to speak to you there, that's fine. It has been suggested to us after the last time we tried these calls that we don't take calls with withheld numbers.
No, we don't, I'm afraid.
We are doing that at the moment, but I think we might have to introduce that rule.
Yeah.
If you withhold your number, then...
So if any of you guys watching tonight would like to speak to Andy or myself, please ring this phone number, and unheld, of course, and we'll let you tonight, but even though, just keep going.
Hi Sarah Rule, watching us from California.
Oh,
sunny California.
So send a little bit of sun to us, please. But even we were talking about the Quarry Bank pub. That was a big outburst last night on our page, and people sending jokes about a pub being on fire. How can you say that? Even stonemasons, the Stonemasons Arms opened the same weekend on Friday. And now they're just joking because they were thinking, oh, they targeted the Quarry Bank pub. How disrespectful is that? That's a pub. It was the fire. It was the chimney that caught on fire. Not because, you know, I just don't like jokes like that.
Your friend Dylan is asking when you got the short back and bean. I think you mean short back and sides.
No, it's a number one all over.
Yeah. And that Quarry Bank fire... people were making jokes, but the Quarry Bank took the mickey out of themselves a little bit, didn't they?
Did they?
They did. Well, their status, they said, we've had a little bit of a hiccup in trading.
Yes, but I think it was the way they said it. And
it's got a bit of understatement of the year, a little bit of a hiccup. But yeah, we're open at 2 o'clock today, weren't we?
Yeah, so, which was good.
We're Altrincham, there's no holding us back.
Yeah. No, too ironic.
Nothing Elfringen can't achieve.
Too ironic. But you know, it's that was one of our little exclusives yesterday, but even though Elfringen today had a little bit with the videos and stuff, but what can you do?
Our friend was there, I don't know. We won't name names on the camera here.
Oh,
okay,
yeah.
We're going to try this one more with no caller ID. Just one more, and then if it's just the same, we'll just take calls from unwithheld numbers. Hello!
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, guys.
Hi, how are you?
Very good, thank you.
Good. Who, what's your name?
Andrew.
Hi, Andrew.
Hey, how are you doing?
Yeah, so what's your question?
Say it. How long have you been doing Elfringen News for?
18 months.
Thereabouts.
8 months?
Yes, 18 months.
Oh dear!
I know! Shocking, isn't it? I thought they'd shut us down by now.
Well.
No. Okay.
Guys, I'll look at that soon.
Okay.
See you later.
Bye bye now.
Now that's the sort of call we like to have instead of people saying about my mother. Anyway.
Excuse me?
Exactly.
You very nearly went there, didn't you?
Well, I don't care.
Anyway, I forgot what we're saying now. What was I saying? Was I just waffling?
I don't know.
Where are we going with this?
Well, you can talk about your bits now for the week ahead.
There's nothing wrong with my bits. My bits don't need talking about.
No, I don't want to know about them bits. I mean, your little bits from what you're working on.
My little bits I've been working on? Yeah. Okay, so I spent a lot of time sat over there in our office. Very cold office, I know.
Heat!
We need heat!
They just go outside, put the studio outside. That's why people like me walk around.
But I tell you what, it's a lot warmer out there. So, yeah, we've got a few letters out and about around Elfringen. We're looking for more help with Elfringen News. And we need to upgrade some equipment and buy some heaters and stuff like that. So, we're running this little video promotion thing. We've done one for Tavern on the Green. Just a little 30-second slot that we can put on our page. To promote your business, tell us any offers you've got on, anything going on, Christmas offers, Christmas events. We'll pop out and get a short video from you, put it on our page. We are regularly reaching 30,000 to 50,000 people a week with the posts on our page, so it's no small deal. There's a lot of people out there who live in and around Elfringen, or who've shown an interest in Elfringen, and if you want to put your video in front of them, give us a shout, and we'll sort something out for you. What do you reckon, mate?
Yes. Well, yeah. Like I was asked on Wednesday to do a live show, which I did in Gift and Home, or Home and Gift, all the way around, it doesn't matter, by two people that work there in the Stamford Quarter, and I did the one in there on Thursday morning, which was nice, actually.
So the Elfringen, I've not been in there myself, but the Elfringen stuff that was in there, that looks pretty good. I'll have to pop in there. Now then, Miles. KFC in Elfringen. Miles is asking if we're...
It's a dump.
KFC in Elfringen. I'm sorry to say, and people have actually pulled me in the past about me having a pop at KFC in Elfringen. I've been in that place 3 times so far, and I'm going to tell it how it is. Each time that I've been in there, the staff have been more interested in what's going on the phones than the customers. There's been crap all over the floor. Yeah, that's what I think of KFC and Elfringen. What's your take on it?
I've only been there twice, I don't go in there anymore.
And why is that, Chris?
Why?
Because it's crap.
Because it's in the wrong place.
It is a little bit out of the way, isn't it?
It should be like where Nando's is, you know, like where Greenwood's is. It should be there, something like around there, you know, near all the food industry.
Okay, Nicola, how do you think you can boost ratings on here? You have just said you have thousands of followers, but not many on live. Well,
it's Sunday.
They're all there on the page, the 8,000, and our figures tell us we're reaching over 30,000 people a week. So, I don't know, people are getting the tea before I'm a celebrity, or...
Oh, celebrity's disgusting, I can't stand that programme.
I quite liked it over the years, I quite got into it, but the last couple of series, I've just not been able to connect with it at all. Probably because I don't know anybody on it. I'm getting too old. Shappy and, what's his name? Stanley Johnson. Those are the only two that I would recognise and to be able to put a name to. But the rest of them, if nobody had told me, I wouldn't have a clue.
Oh, hi Karen, you okay, sweetie? How are you?
Hey Karen. So you're not a fan of celebrity? What,
no. I don't even want to say it.
It can't be that bad.
It is, it's
oh
nasty.
Oh my lord. No, I've not been able to get into it this year at all.
Oh Gavin, I'm watching from the back of a taxi en route from Warrington
to Lynn. Oh.
Manchester City Centre tomorrow night.
You're actually getting closer to us. You're normally watching from down south.
It's alright, isn't it?
Yeah.
People.
Party? Are you going to the party?
I should have been at a party tonight. My work's due tonight, but I let them down because I wanted to do a live.
Yeah, well, whatever you're up to, Gavin, I hope it goes well for you. And thank you, Gavin. We had a little exchange of messages last week. And thanks for your support, Gavin.
Yeah, so I've missed my work's due tonight. But hey, I've got one on Thursday afternoon at work itself.
In the afternoon?
Yes. Free food for the staff, which is nice. I love turkey. Do you like turkey?
I'm trying to think of a stuffing gag here, but no, I've decided against that. No, I'm not actually a fan of turkey.
Well, we knew that last year. so I'm not going to go down that route.
No, you're totally foxed me now.
No. Miss Altrincham, where are you, Miss Altrincham? I love it. I'm the queen of Altrincham, get that. Oh yeah, especially on my new Twitter page that Andy set up for me, oh my word.
It's Chris!
Woohoo!
Yeah, so it's Chris _ woohoo. Give the guy a follow.
Exactly, it's not my fault I love Altrincham, I just, people just woohoo at me. It's like, okay, woohoo, oh yeah, woohoo, I'm just going out tonight and I'm going, woohoo! It's everything's about woohoo.
You love it, don't you?
Well, sort of. It's like Andy Spurt said, oh Chris, do you know what I've done for you? I've made you a page, and what was it about? It's just about you woohooing around Altrincham. So I looked at it, and I keep looking at it. Anyway, we've got a call now, guys, just to let you know.
Okay.
Hello?
Good evening.
Hi, Chris.
Hiya, who's it? Altrincham News. Just to let you know, it's at Altrincham News, not Altrincham Today.
You tell them.
You tell them.
Please read. If you can't read it properly...
Be nice to the people.
Yeah, Altrincham Today. Sorry. Not funny. Yes, get used to it. Who? Yes. Oh, I'm a bum boy. Anyway, let's just carry on while these are speaking about anything. So anyway, Chris Atkinson's online. Hi Chris, you alright?
Are they still going on over there?
Yeah, it's alright, just I'm not listening.
Hi Chris Aki, how you doing buddy?
In it, yo, Chris is a batty boy, yo, woohoo! Oh, stop it.
Suitable, that was well dealt with, that, Chris. Yeah, well dealt with.
I don't care. Oh, anyway, Alshingham's chocolate lovers. That's put my night right. Alshingham chocolate lovers. No.
The Banter Brothers.
The Banter Brothers.
I can't do that Manchester stuff.
In it, Altair.
That reminds me, can it say Altair?
Altair.
Oh, you've got it now. You've mastered that one, haven't you? Altair.
Oh, actually, I've just realised that person's put his number on it online.
Didn't they?
Thanks for that, mate.
No.
I'll send it to police.
No. Now, your number's safe with us. Confidentiality and all that, I guess we have to abide by the rules. So, yeah, don't worry. You won't be hearing off us. We won't return any nasty excuse me.
Yeah, we just...
I've got a winter chest.
Oh, Rita. Oh, our friend Rita, the other Rita, by
the way. Rita.
Hi, Rita, you all right?
Hi, that Rita.
I haven't seen you for ages, how are you?
Yeah, not since you threatened to turn up at the Timperley Country Fair.
And
back in September?
Up. Yeah, we haven't spoken since then. What's going on, love?
Yeah, you said you wanted to come down at the studio. We've still got to sort that out, haven't we? Yeah, so, Rita, yeah. You're more than welcome to come join us one night if you want. Come and sit here, Rita.
Yeah, that's if she can keep up with us, babe.
Might keep us a bit warmer having somebody else in the middle here. Oh, stop it! Stop it. So, what else have we got tonight, Chris? Because we've managed to fill half an hour with garbage so far.
Garbage? It's all been about Altrincham and people talking to me about being Batty Boy!
Oh, okay.
I don't care! I really don't care, I'm just like, in it, Batty Boy, yo, in it, yo, in it, yo. Chris is a Batty Boy from all of yo, in it. Altrincham News, not Altrincham Today. Get your
facts.
We
get that a lot, don't we?
Yeah, I got it yesterday. I was like, it's like Altrincham News, I thought, hey? Altrincham Today, is like, oh my god. And I was on the metro and somebody said, good evening, Altrincham. I said, did they got off? I was like, it would have been not me. But I don't care, we're us. We're
all together. Rita, yeah, more than welcome to bring your friend Julie.
Yeah, we'd love it. We'd love a bit of action. Audience.
Just let me clear that up a little bit.
Audience, you know what I mean? Action audience. Sorry.
Right, stick to your script, man. Stick to your script.
Yes, I've got a big script today.
Is that what you call it?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, so long as you keep it to yourself. It isn't my cup of tea.
No.
No.
Not like Santa. Naughty man! Rita called me a naughty man! Anyway. Naughty man. Anyway. Yeah, let's just...
So... What else have we got then, Chris? We're just getting back into the swing of these Sundays. It's been a few weeks since we were sat here.
Yes.
Tell us again about your walk-arounds coming up this week.
Yeah, I will be live on Tuesday. I'm not sure on the where I will be yet, but just keep watching the page for updates.
Are you open to suggestions where people would like you to go?
Yeah, around the region of Altrincham, Timperley, Hale. I won't go around there. Anywhere really, just make sure it's distance, to be honest.
We've promised a few people that we'd do one down on Atlantic Street.
I was thinking about that. I was with Joe the other day and I was going to take some pictures, but it was too cold to do it.
Oh, bless you.
I can do one.
Well, you've got that big orange coat now.
Oh yeah, the one over there. I love my new coat.
Yeah. Stood outside having a crafty fag. In the studio before waiting for Chris, and I could see him a mile away down there, like this big orange glow. You've probably seen the pictures of him on the page, innit? It's a lovely warm coat, that.
Yeah, people notice me, yeah, which I'm like, okay!
They can woohoo at you from a mile away, can't they? So, Tuesday, at what time?
8 o'clock.
8 o'clock, Tuesday, be there for Chris. And you're doing two this week?
On Thursday, at 8:30, 8 o'clock, around that, and then we've got our meeting.
Yeah, and I'm sandwiched in the middle there. I wasn't able to do one last Wednesday, but sandwiched in the middle on Wednesday at 8:30, join me. Here, please do.
Oh?
Yeah. Okay, right, well, I think, Chris, we need to be pressing on, maybe getting out of here. Should we give this one more go? 07874055611. Show us the coat.
Nah, it's alright. No, I don't want to. Because people be like, oh, actually, okay.
Go and get your coat. Yeah. So.
I just realised what I missed out on my line as well.
Oh, what was that then?
Talking about my fashion show.
Oh, you're having a fashion. Oh, your fashion show, yeah.
Look, see.
How sexy is that?
Ooh, look at that, ooh. Oh dear.
Miles, yes, I am a smoker.
Yes, but not that sort of smoke, by the way.
Sort of on and off. I do possess an e-cig, which I try and use, but...
You lose it, don't you?
I am one of them smoker people, but I do try the e-cig, so...
It's all good.
I'm making an effort. Kick that habit! So, yeah, sexy coat, Chris.
Yes, I know, it's nice. It's nice and warm. It's just right for my walk around and doing what I can do, you know, for Oxygen News, of course.
So, tell us about this fashion show.
Yeah, it was at the Laundry B on Stamford New Road with Laura and her staff. It was really good. They raised over £474, something like that. In that night, which went all down to cancer research and breast cancer, and what's it called? One second, Sea Rider.
That's the one.
And quite a good cause. It was really busy. I did a live show, well, two on there, showing you a bit of a fashion walk. Really good girls doing that. Good Andy didn't go because Andy likes girl legs.
I'm a leg man.
He is.
Yeah.
Yeah, especially you at the Altingham Festival.
The festival?
Altingham Festival.
But you might have to remind me about that, but maybe not on camera.
Yeah. Hi there, Chris and Andy. I really enjoy tuning, even though I live in St. Urban's. I was brought up in Altingham, but it looks through. It's all because it's quite trendy now.
Altrincham is quite trendy now, isn't it?
I know.
Proper upmarket.
They're getting that new flannels place in Stamford Quarter that's opening next month as well. They've put the brand on the window, which looks really good.
Mm.
Instead of a big logo thing that's lit up, it's just it's on the window.
Still looking for staff and all, aren't they? And just on the window there. So if you fancy being a flanneler.
I actually thought we were going to take the whole building. They're actually only taking half of it.
Maybe they'll expand, said the vicar to the tart. I've not used that line for ages.
Yeah.
No. Oh dear.
You're not allowed.
Miles used to make me LOL.
What do you want?
We try.
Actually, no, you don't want that certain person we saw yesterday.
The thing is, though, Chris, are we trying to make them lol? Because if they're lolling when we're trying, when we're not trying to, then that's not good.
Does it matter, Andy, does it?
No, these Sundays are just a little bit of a let your hair down and let loose a little bit. let your hair down. Right, okay. Alright, once more guys, 07874055611. If you'd like to call and give us some abuse, like our earlier caller, that's fine.
Yeah, and if you ring again that certain person, I will definitely put the phone down straight away, because don't tolerate any of that. Thank you.
You put your foot down with a firm hand, Chris.
Yeah, they'll have a firm hand in a minute.
Okay.
Yeah, that was another thing.
What's that?
Was it 2 weeks ago when I was watching a walk around on the Sunday? People decided to destroy the Stamford Quarter. with the plants and ripping plants out.
Yeah.
Which is on the go in quite a lot of...
That was a mess.
Search, you know.
It was a mess, that was a shame, that. Although, on a positive note, the week after, Altrincham and Bloom were in Barclays on George Street doing a cake sale.
Yeah!
And,
yeah!
No,
yeah!
Wait a minute! Wait a minute! You can take the piss out of me in a minute. Again, another good £400 Altrincham and Bloom raised there, so thank you for your support if you donated cakes or popped in and bought one. And it, go on, get it out of your system.
No, never.
I was only going to say that you wore an apron in the middle of Altrincham.
A penny.
And a little badge.
Dressed me up in a red polka dot pin. I thought it suited me.
Should have got a picture.
I think
but then
one.
Again, I was too busy because I wanted the latte before I started by my little shouting business.
Did you get out there doing some shouting?
I did.
Throwing people in.
Yes, I did. I even got Karen from, what's it called? Fish Bar. From Altrincham Fish
Karen.
Bar. And she was like, no, I'm not, I'm on Weight Watchers, but I think that was the only person I could get in. Sarah got everyone else. It's like, yeah, you do the work then, Sarah, you know, but it was good. It was good to have a bit of fun and have loads of them cakes. Oh, especially the, what's it called? The brownies. They're really nice. Okay. See, he doesn't like me talking, does he?
I'm
just really happy today, Andy.
It's the things that you come out with, you see, like brownies. I'm constantly trying to think of a quick gag.
Yeah, you don't get away with it anymore.
It's not happening tonight. Miles, apparently you lols all the time at us. LOL! WTF!
Oh yeah, that was another WTF that I got on Friday morning on Oxford Road with that massive pile of rubbish on a bin, which has been emptied by Amy.
It has, hasn't it?
Yes. Angela? Was it Angie that did another one for Mary on Goose Green Bridge?
Angela Stone.
Yeah, she cleared the rubbish on the Goose Green.
She got
Amy
to remove all them bins. But was that just for that parade, and then we're going to see them back on the top of the bridge?
They did that with the with the Goose Green Festival. They did it again. So they might be there by tomorrow.
Well, wherever them bins were, I saw the picture of where they'd moved to, but I can't remember exactly where it was. Let's hope they stay there.
They look better there, much cleaner.
But a couple of things about that picture that you put on the page with the bins. First of all, quite a few people have sent us some pictures to the page since then. So we're going to keep holding them for a while, and because every 2 or 3 months it seems to build up, this problem with Amy, and it comes to a head, all the rubbish in the town centre. So we'll collect these pictures together for now, because we find that a bit of public shaming normally works with Amy. Normally gets them off their arses and gets something done. So if you've got any pictures, if you see anything, let us know. The other thing about that is that some people were saying on the page, Chris, that if the bins are full, then don't put stuff in it. Find another bin.
Yeah, you should see the rest of it now. Since it's been clear, you should see round the bin. It's got, it's behind Sainsbury's, and it's all full of rubbish right round. I think it's been like that for about a week.
People shouldn't have to find another bin. No, Amy are contracted to do this work, and as everybody in Altrincham knows now, they're just not cutting the mustard at all, are they? They just can't get the stuff together. No. And I know the bins where I live, it went 3 weeks without them being emptied. Amy, maybe we'll drop Amy a message publicly on Twitter or something and ask them, can you tell us what your schedule is for bin emptying in Altrincham, and let's see if you play ball with us, and then we'll be able to hold them more to account, and everybody will know when the bins are supposed to be emptied.
Another job for them as well.
if they don't get done, we can get on the case, can't we? We can look after Altrincham.
Oh yes. Yes, definitely, Andy. Chris, have you ever thought about running for Altrincham MP? Actually, that'd be quite cool. Yeah, you'll have to ask Graham Brady for that bit, because he's the MP for World Champions.
He was here last week.
Yeah.
Graham Brady. He came to have a look round.
No, I wouldn't do it. It's, I just enjoy what I do.
Yeah. You do enjoy them walk arounds, don't you?
Yeah, especially when people like run around like Joanne, when she's in the middle of a pudding and she sees me, she talks to me online, next minute she's running out the door, coming out, and it's like, whoa! You know, that's the sort of thing I like, because that's altering them, and it makes people like going, oh my God, why is that guy doing that? Because I love it. People don't understand why I enjoy it so much. I'm talking about altering them, it's like, you know, I'm proud to be an alternate.
It's your thing, isn't it, these walk-arounds?
Yeah.
You'd do them 5 days a week, 7 days a week if you could.
Yeah. Oh, no. Oh, no.
Is that a little bit too much?
No, I don't mind the odd one. Like, yesterday was, like, you know, like, the Lantern Parade, and people trying to wait you because they were trying to get in front of you.
Oh, yeah, I started talking about that, didn't I? And we weren't naming, but that certain individual who's not very popular with us, she was like,
he's actually trying to be a diva himself.
Yeah.
Well, in the last post he's put, because it's like, oh, I'll take a picture of Star Wars. Oh, no, I'll take a picture. And I'm thinking, well, hang on a minute.
Yeah, we were, the pair of us were jostling for position at the front of that parade. It was quite funny. Well, we'll leave that one there.
Yes, exactly, we should leave him.
Although our paths did cross a couple of weeks ago, and it wasn't as, there wasn't as much tension there as normal, so it'd be nice to think that, yeah, Altrincham needs to get on and everybody needs to work together. I doubt it'll happen with this guy, but it would be nice to see. We're open to that. Altrincham is one.
Yeah.
And that's how it should be.
Definitely one.
Okay. Well, I think are we just about done, Chris?
I'm just trying to think what to say, because
we've
done quite a lot tonight, actually, in an under 50 minutes, but we'll talk a little bit more, because people are enjoying it, because it's fun.
Okay.
But
knock yourself out?
Well, you can do that.
Oh, I'll do that for you.
No, yeah. You better not.
Fine. I'm sure I can find, there's a little portable heater down there.
Oh, no, I'll do that. You'll be cold.
I'm always cold.
Yeah, I know. Always cold, especially, it's like, okay, Andy, okay.
Everybody's got one of their mates who's always cold. I'm that person.
Yeah.
Maybe it's an age thing.
But yeah, maybe. But I'm cold, actually, now. I'm just wearing my nice little jumper that I got on my house. Anyway. So anyway, yeah, I actually think we should do all this to a close.
Okie dokie.
But it's been a good one. It's been a funny one.
Nice to get back into it there. So yeah, so watch out for Chris. 8 o'clock Tuesday. I'll be with you 8:30 Wednesday. And then Chris again
Thursday. I mean, breakfast show, so I might be twice on Thursday.
Just going to say about your breakfast show.
Yeah, I'm just trying to get. I'm trying to get somewhere at the moment, which I can't tell you either, because you'll end up jumping on me.
So, I'm not doing that again. So you can't commit yourself to the breakfast show.
No, I'm doing the breakfast show at 9 o'clock on Thursday and at 8 o'clock.
You heard it first, do you?
Yes. So watch out. And keep watching our page and what we're doing, because we do so much for Altrincham.
If you'd like Chris to come and visit you to do a breakfast show from your establishment, I'm sure he'd be more than willing, wouldn't you?
At chris@altrincham.news.
Yep. chris@altrincham.news. Drop him an email or drop us a message to the page. We'll sort it.
Yeah, definitely.
You like that, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Especially if there's food involved. Or a big English breakfast.
I'm not going to the Oxford Cafe, especially their rating.
Ooh! I was just going to be subtle about that. I read that information that you sent over.
Yes.
I'll leave that one with you.
It was on Hail and Altrincham Live. Sorry, Nigel. It was on another medium page in Altrincham. The the Oxford Cafe have got a rating of 2, which is quite embarrassing. So I'll just leave that one there, let people go and have a look at that. Hale and Altrincham Life, it's on, so go and have a look on there. So, you didn't hear that from me. I don't mind it, I've been in there for a drink, but that's all I've had.
I've been a couple of times and I quite like it in there.
Yeah, but would you give it a 2 though?
I don't know, we don't get to see the kitchen and stuff, do we? I also know Nat and Stan from Barney Sarney. The other year they had a bit of issues with health and safety people, and it was just simply a straightforward issue under a sink. The hygiene wasn't a problem, it was just a box that wasn't ticked, couldn't be ticked for some reason, which had no effect whatsoever on the hygiene. So, I don't know, the thing is, if it's done, it's got to be done right, there's got to be a line somewhere, I suppose.
No, Chris Atkinson's just said, try the Red House Farm in Dunham, Massey, the food is amazing.
I've never been.
Nor have I. There's so many food industries in Altrincham now, I don't know where to start. I haven't even tried Nando's since they've opened, even though I don't want to go in there, because, as you say about the chicken, I'd rather go there than go to KFC.
Oh God, yeah.
So at least we can go there and just enjoy it, but even still, why would you line up for your food? I still don't understand. You go into Nando's, sit down, go and queue up, and sit down again. Why don't they just come round to your table and order it? That's how I would pay, say, £10 for a meal.
You're very old school.
I am though, but that's the thing though, Andy. If you go to the Wetherspoons, you will expect to get up for £5 to order panini and a drink and then go and sit down again. I'd expect that, but if you go to Nando's, you've got to go and queue up and order your dinner.
I'm not a fan of that spicy chicken, but I guess I'm a bit boring with food, because I don't visit Subway, because I walk in there, all this stuff on the board.
Oh, like, Subway.
What the hell's that?
Subway's one of my favourite food industries in Altrincham. I love it. I go there like 3 times a week, twice a week.
One of my mates is always complaining because he's like me, and he says, I just want a cheese butty. Just a cheese butter.
Chris actually said, I will tell you a few stories about KFC. I've never been there.
I'll never eat there.
Never eat there. Oh, I've eaten there, well, in Altrincham about twice. But KFC somewhere else maybe a few times. But.
I've never been a fan of KFC in general, but I've never, ever, ever had a good experience in the Altrincham branch, I'm afraid. And that's how it is. That's how it is.
Yeah, you tell him, Andy.
I will! I've never had a good experience in the Altrincham branch. There, I told it how it is.
Yeah, maybe get some staff that can cook and serve properly and retrain them. Otherwise, we might go in there and do a live show, maybe.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah. That'll be fun, wouldn't it?
You have undetectors, you know.
Yeah, maybe we should do that. Just go in there, grab a bite to eat, and all of a sudden do a live stream from there. I would, however, recommend, we like the fish bar, don't we?
Oh, Altrincham Fish Bar. I was in there on Wednesday.
And the Don, we're fans of the Don, Chippy. We like it there.
Yeah.
So, yeah, if you would like to send us some free food.
Well, you know, somebody else might get us free food.
Like the cakes we had with Kate the other week.
Oh, yeah.
Cakes! I was never a fan of cakes and all until I started eating them. I'm like, cakes aren't bad, are they?
No, they're quite sweet. You know that, what's it called? One minute. That was another thing I wanted to bring up tonight. What's it called? The ice cream and dessert place.
Fireworks.
On the fireworks. Why is it closed? What's going on there? It keeps closing. How are you making money? Even though it's winter, people might not want to go there. How are you running it? It should open. It's been closed last every time I've walked past it.
I think they've closed, haven't they?
They should reopen again. Well, not. They should. Somebody just let us know what's going on. Because we did an exclusive there with free ice cream and everything with the nice young lady. she left because of the members of staff in there as well, after what happened, because they were paying her to tell people other stories.
Mm. They didn't get off on the right foot, really, did they?
No.
Round there. So, well, maybe it's our live stream. We did stitch them up. Who knows? If you'd like us to come and put your business out of business, then let us know.
I wouldn't do that. Oh, yeah, KFC in Altrincham, you're down.
We're down there.
Yeah.
You're next.
Anyway, right, sorry, guys. We will be leaving you now. I'm really sorry, but... Thank you very much for watching and supporting Altrincham News. We do love doing our work, don't we, Andy?
We do. It's fun.
But if you'd like to add anything to the page, just message us and we'll give you some information how to do that. And we'll see you all very soon, Altrincham.
Yep. Take care, Altrincham. I'll see you soon. We have a problem here, though, don't we? With nobody on the side of the camera.
Actually, I'd rather do that, actually, because other people like Joe have things to do.
Right, take care, Altrincham. See you soon. Bye-bye now.